situated here. What am I doing? I'm smoking a bow. No, I'm not smoking a bowl. I'm not in the weed. I've been accused of drinking a beer here or there, and very occasionally wine, as long as it's a Riesling. I don't mind the Rieslings. I am, in fact, smoking, hanging up here, a Sinewback bowl. Serves two purposes. The first is the heat helps the bow to cure, the sinew to dry. And you shall see it in that this bow that was sinew-backed just a mere grouping of days ago has already gone in the reflex. It is gaining reflex from the sinew. The second reason, though, is I am probably not going to put some kind of finish like grease or water protectant on the sinew. You know, if it happens to get wet, I'm saying this now, it might pass out of my hands, and if it does, I will finish it. But if it was my bow and it got wet, got caught in the rain, I just bring it home and let it dry out. Big deal. It started out wet. It can get wet along the way. But this smoking will help it gain protection from humidity and water. The resins in the cedar bark will help waterproof the sinew. Plus, it'll smell nice. Let's get that bow down. I need to build racks up there. And the heat from the fire's not going to hurt it. It's going to help it. Oh, it loves it. It loves that heat and the smoke. You can see that it's starting to bend back quite a bit from the sinew yanking at it. And that's only a single layer. That's one benefit of sinew backing wider, thin bows than it is like, say, if this was narrower and thicker. I like that big old surface area of the sinew, and then helps bring it backwards. Oh, that feels so good. I was able to actually do a little patchwork on it because somewhere in here, I forget where it is. I can't see it. It's not visible at all. There was a thick sinew fiber that went up somehow, and then there was a crevice under it. So I just sanded it off and then patched it with another few groupings of sinew fibers. And I can do that because I didn't finish it with grease or anything like that. It gives you the ability to fix a bow. And also, if this wood happened to break somehow down the road, and I didn't put grease or Helmsman spar urethane varnish on the back, I could reclaim that sinew and use it on another bow. And so there are a lot of good reasons why not to finish the sinew portion. I could certainly grease the belly or put Helmsman spar urethane on the belly, but at the same time leaving the sinew plain and accepting the fact that I could repair it, and if it gets wet, I just let it dry. Now, as far as protecting the sinew from moisture, I could put birch bark on it, very thin, papery layers, and they usually put a cross grain perpendicular to the lay of the bow. Or I could put snakeskin on it, and maybe grease the snakeskin, which would allow me to peel that snakeskin off, and then not have grease on the sinew, you see? So you think about stuff like this. Now, as a note, I let loose a grouping of 3 and 5 bend bows upon the world. None of them should be used yet. At the end of April, you know, then start using them. So in the next few days, I am going to do a little treatise, a video on stringing these bows, these sinew back bows, brace height suggestions, and draw length. I'm gonna end this video. I'm bragging. You might not have this, but you can have it. Oh, interesting. I pulled this out. This is, anyway, the Native American Bows, Arrows, and Quivers Volume 2, which covers the plains in the Southwest. And I opened it to, this surprised me, a short, narrow Osage orange bow, and what do you see on the back? Bark. Osage bows in this book from the plains is viewed from museum artifacts. A lot of the Osage bows still had sapwood on the back. You know, so the notion that you have to work them down to a single growth ring, it is kind of false. They all seem to have the heartwood on the belly, but it apparently can be like a situation like an English longbow that's made out of yew, where they have the heartwood on the belly and the sapwood on the back. Something to think about. A lot of these bows, very small, very simple, not decorated much at all, made from small branches, and you can see the pith in them. So these are very simple bows. So you might say, well, the people of the Southwest and the Plains didn't do a lot with their archery as far as a lot of time in producing it. However, what strikes me, let's look at this bow case and quiver. I mean, the bow cases and the quivers and the associated awl pouches and the fire tool pouches and everything that were on them, like beautiful utility belts, these things were made to last. There's another one. This is made out of bobcat, the one on this side, mountain lion. Amazing work. So to say that they weren't as artistic with their archery equipment as like the West Coast natives, the Hoopa and the Modoc and all the other ones, is false, because the Plains and the Southwest tribes put a lot of thought and effort into the bow cases and the quivers, or the quivers or what have you. That would lead me into believing, just like their arrows were very utilitarian, you know, they will break, they will get lost, so don't waste a lot of time turning them into objects d'art. The bow is the same way. Very simple, probably didn't last, you know, as long as some other bows made out there. They were short, they were highly stressed, you know, and so things would happen. Just a few observations. Well, I managed to get through this take. I literally did like 10 videos so far and deleted them all because they started going into rants about other things. I will leave it at that. I would encourage you to pick up volumes 1 and 2. And if you know if there's a volume 3 that includes West Coast native bows, please tell me in the comment section. Give me a link, because I haven't been able to find one of the encyclopedias that includes the West Coast bows. And I know there has to be one out there. I have faith. That was nice. This is so much fun. Anyway, have a good one. And I wish you luck in your digging holes in frozen ground. I have to dig a whole bunch of holes now in frozen ground. That's why I'm stalling. Yep.